excellent.
Ow. Leave her in there.
It's your new bed.
You're silly.
What are you doing, Sarah?
Painting mom's toenails.
Wow.
I'm one.
You painted her
mama.
Toes so well. Wow. It smells so good in here, doesn't it?
It goes right to the head.
Mm-hmm. It stinks.
Yeah. Beautiful, Sarah.
I did it, all of this with this color.
Ooh, pretty. Have you seen them yet?
Oh, wow. I love the two-toned. Uh-huh. Oh, that's amazing.
Yeah. Thank you, Mama.
That's amazing. Thank you, Sarah, for my beautiful pedicure.
Do you want your nails?
You know, I don't like my nails painted ever. Thank you so much, though.
You're welcome. I'm going to paint my own nails.
Oh, that'll be great. Do it at the table, okay? All right, can I just say this child is amazing. I was busy getting my pedicure done. And, you know, just amazingness there. And I asked Emma to come and just throw some, a friend gave us some stew meat. And so I was like, well, throw it together in a pot. And she didn't know what to do with it. And she rose to the challenge. And it smells amazing. It smells amazing.
I'm starving.
I think it's done.
You think it's done? But it was hard for her to do. And I'm really proud of her. Good job, Em. Mm. Boom. Boom. Fabulous bake. Fabulous. It's not a bake. Fabulous cook. So she's worried if it's done. And stew meat is tough. So that's okay. Let's see. That's hot. That's really hot. Can I try some? That's amazing.
Is it really? Is it good?
It's really good.
Can I put some on some bread?
We're going to cook up some rice. And, eat it that way. That'll be really good. Wonder if we could make like add some water and make a sauce and pour it over rice.
Can I try some?
Mmm. All those onions.
Can I try some?
Good job. Hard throw together dinner's the best. And what's funny is I'm a recipe gal, recipe all the way. I don't make things up. Some people have a talent. I don't. But yeah, we've thrown this together. So Emma did onion, salt, and pepper, right, babe?
Mm-hmm.
And then we decided to saute the rice right inside, added a little bit of water, a little bit of coconut aminos / soy sauce, some sour cream and peas. Dinner's done.
It tastes delicious. I haven't tried it with the sour cream.
With the sour cream, I can't taste it because of the dairy. But Missy's going to taste it right now, and that's going to be a really hot piece. Be careful.
Really good.
Really good?
Mm-hmm. Not many burned my mouth off, though. But that's amazing.
Is it amazing?
Amazing. I'm glad we added the sour cream.
Awesome. Well, you need some strength because you've got some outside stuff to do. We gotta clean up the chicken coop. Dun dun dun.
Dun dun dun.
And another plate bites the dust. I don't know if you can see it, but there's a crack all the way through. Oh. I need to just invest in some, what's it called? The stainless steelware. That way they don't break. Because no. I'm anti-plastic and I'm anti-paint on the plates.
Get some glass plates that don't have paint.
So. But they still will break. Oh, I just need to invest in some better plates. He's our lone survivor. In an effort to save our hens from being overbred, missing feathers on their backs, because we just don't need four roosters for our hens, I want two. I want to have two. So Jonah processed two of our other roosters. We're hoping that our sweet hens can regrow their feathers. And I can't believe how much quieter it was this morning on the homestead as we all woke up in the morning. It wasn't the tabernacle chorus of roosters.
No broody hens.
Yeah, over there.
I know.
All right, we gotta get this done before they put themselves to bed. No, it's disgusting in there. Come on, let's get it done.
I got mud boots.
You've got, yeah, but that's gross.
I'd really like to close off this coop. I'm not sure why I didn't think of it before, but I could have just cleaned it out, closed it off, and let the broody hens do their own thing inside the coop. We do have the chickshaw as well, which is a great summer place for them to be. It's nice that the poop falls down and you can clean it. Occasionally, you get poop that is built up in the bottom. So I'm going to get some little people in there so they can kind of push it down through the grates. And then it all goes to the compost system. Then, you know, it's great. I'm new to compost and it's been really fun. We add to this, move to this, move to this. So, really, really kind of cool. You what?
I found one egg with poop.
You found one egg with poop?
Yeah. Come on. These are the eggs.
Oh. What are they doing right there?
No, they were in there.
Oh, you got them out of there. Okay.
They were all the way in there.
Okay, well, will you
right there.
Get the egg and wipe the poop off on the ground. Don't step on it. Here, grab the sides and wipe it off.
Okay.
Like a tough farm girl.
Yeah.
Oh, don't drop them. Careful.
Okay. Sometimes I'll be... careful.
Oh, yes. Good job, Sarah. You can wipe it on that log right there.
Yeah.
Careful. Good job. Sometimes you get poopy eggs, huh?
Yep.
Good job.
Look off.
Oh, did you crack it?
No.
Oh, don't do it hard. You're going to crack it.
That was the best I can do.
Okay, thank you.
These are the ones that
is it cracked?
No.
I'm surprised. All right. Good job. Okay, where are you going with those? We gotta get the basket. So put it down and go get the basket.
Put them down.
Sarah, seriously.
Eggs and two more.
You're stressing me out. Go get the basket. Thanks.
Do we just dump the stuff on the floor?
Dump it on the ground and we'll scoop it up.
Okay.
Capiche? Aw, oh, the goats. We need to come in and tidy up their pen, too. I like to kind of sweep it up and get all that poop
to use in the compost. And then it keeps their area a little bit cleaner and nice.
Good job, baby. How many eggs are there?
1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6.
Good job. Well, that's a lot, Sarah.
There's 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16, 17.
That's some pretty good counting there, baby.
I didn't know how to count like that. What? It's after 16.
17.
17.
Yep.
18, 19, 20.
20 eggs.
There's more.
Did she count all of them or just count them twice?
I don't know. There's more? That's great.
We put the roosters down yesterday and we had a decline in eggs, and I think the animals really can feel the loss on the homestead. I really, really do. So I kind of attributed the loss of eggs to the loss of the day. But that's two more roosters we don't have to feed. And it's just more quiet.
Awesome job. Now we'll just get the pitchfork and fill it up.
Yeah.
Awesome. The chicken party. I'm gonna let them do a little bit of work for me. Spread that around, put a little more poop on it. It'll be epic.
I finished. I think it looks pretty good to me. I'm not supposed to do too many. Not too many, but too much. And so, I think it looks good.
The recipe for getting much needed rain is to come out and do some work, because we're feeling a couple sprinkles, but I really doubt it's gonna last. Getting just in general, trying to get things straightened up and nice. You know, it's like the house. You don't know how it gets so dirty so quickly. We're not even out here all the time, but it's nice to get things cleaned up. I hope that we get some rain.
What you doing?
You enjoying your time with the chicken, Missy?
Yeah, you... Yep. Cleaning out the poo. I'm a chicken housekeeper.
Oh, great. A chicken housekeeper. Well, have fun, chicken housekeeper.
And you too.
This is called using your chickens to your own advantage. This is old straw from the when we surrounded the shack with straw. And I took off all the twine, and I love seeing them get it spreading around. We're gonna water down this stuff we just added to the compost. And I'm really loving the compost. I think I already said that, but it's just kind of fun. It's a fun process, and I'm new at it, but we're working it out. Doing my work in my Homestead flip-flops because I can't ruin my pedicure job, so that's super fun.
Better get out of there before it's your home permanently.
Yeah. So sweaty in here. Yeah.
The rain stopped. We need rain so bad. Oh, I don't want to water this down too much. Like I said, I'm new to this, but I know you're supposed to keep it moist, so I figure a little bit is good. We love this water, water nipple system. I really want to do something like this for the rabbits. We had somebody suggest to that, so thank you. I think we're gonna dump it out and put some fresh water in there. I'm just not exactly sure. I don't want to hurt the nipples. I can't use that water for good. Oh well. We are giving the chickens fresh water. It's raining.
Like harder than it has.
And it's not even hard. It's raining. If we do the rain dance, will it keep starting? Is that the rain dance?
Mm-hmm. Good job.
We're almost ready to go inside. It's amazing how just coming out and cleaning things can make your heart happy. Always more to do on the homestead. We might have to go inside. It's really raining. I love finding the beauty in the weeds. I didn't plant those, but aren't they gorgeous? I love blooming where you're planted. We live in a very dry area. This is drier than dry. The rain didn't keep up, it stopped. A little bit of a sprinkle here and there, which is not awesome, but you know, we live in a desert. So we'll just pray for some rain as we need it, and we'll just carry on. But we'd like to thank you for coming along today with us on this crazy adventure that we like to call homesteading. Give us that thumbs up, and hopefully we'll see you tomorrow.
Misty mountains, dusty roads ahead.